You're no longer in the service. Only an outsider can find the double agent.
I'll do my utmost.
The plot of Tinker Tailor is in fact quite straightforward.
All I want from you is one code name.
But around it are these complex characters who are completely and utterly fully realized.
It is one of these men. Tinker.
You just feel it's got infinite possibilities.
What the hell are you doing up here?
Tailor.
There's actually more meat on the bone than you know what to do with.
Soldier.
I'm looking at this movie as a work of art in itself, which took off from the book I wrote.
Spy.
For 25 years, we've been the only thing standing between Moscow and the Third World War.
One of my earliest thoughts was, who were the soldiers of the Cold War?
Things aren't always what they seem.
When I saw the first draft, I thought that was a piece of dramatic and intellectual architecture that I could really admire.
We talked from the beginning with Thomas about finding ways to tell the story with just two images, which is sort of always the job, you know, but particularly in this case, using dialogue only as a last resort, almost.
When we were actually designing, we have tried to create something which really gives you the atmosphere of men who are working in a world of deceit, like in the book.
We tended to want to change this on the novel with John, you know, and say, John, does this feel right? Does it feel part of the world?
He's basically been a part of this whole process.
I was in the intelligence community during the great witch hunt periods, and so I'm there as a resource, that's all.
I rang him and talked to him for an hour. He's in Axis Dream, anything you ask him about backstory, and it's there. So it was almost like interviewing Gwilym. It was wonderful.
One of the most memorable moments for me was the scene in which we're studying the document.
Take a look at this nonsense.
I hadn't any dialogue for that scene, which is fine. So nothing more enjoyable, actually, than playing a scene where you don't speak.
And cut.
Thomas, after the first rehearsal, said, no, I think it's a bit odd that you don't say anything, so I think we need a line. So they got John Le Carré on the phone, and about 10 minutes later, the line was brought in, and I felt it almost should have come in on a velvet cushion. You know, here's your customized line, written especially for you, sir.
Style appalling. Patently a fabrication. This could be the real thing.
It was a wonderful moment. It's wonderful to have him so closely connected.
That was fantastic.
It's a huge thrill to get together among very creative people who work in a different medium and watch it from the outside. I mean, it's a great buzz. It's wonderful.
We're not so very different, you and I. We're both looking for the weaknesses in one another.